A lot of good things happening, Coach. Let's start with the defense in the second half. 31% is all you allowed Lamar. Everything they got was a struggle, and you guys made it awfully difficult defensively on them in the second half.
Yeah, I thought we did a really good job of taking away what they wanted to do. You know, it started with good post defense. We kind of dig down, meaning that if your man throws the ball inside, we go send a second defender. I thought that kind of messed with him a little bit. And the guy we needed to stay close to, Garth, we did for the most part. And was really happy with our defense. I wish we'd have rebounded a little bit better. But, you know, they only beat us by 4 on the glass, and a lot of those offensive rebounds came late game. But I was happy with the defensive performance.
Matthew Modest here is our player of the game, Coach. 5 of 7 from the floor, and he missed a layup that he had earned himself a great look at. 1 of 1 from 3, 2 of 3 from the free throw line. How about 4 boards, 4 assists, 0 turnovers in 25 minutes? Extremely solid from your Swiss Army knife.
Yeah, he stuffed the stat sheet on that one. And, you know, that's the kind of guy we think Matthew is. He can come up with those kind of numbers. And he also played incredible defense. He's just, you know, he's a big, strong kid. And when his when he's locked into what we're doing, he's awful special. And as a coach, you love a guy with that versatility. That's the thing that Matthew, I think, brings to our team. But really, really proud of him. He's accepted a role of being what I think is the best sixth man, maybe in the conference. He could start for a lot of people, including us. But his role is to do kind of what he did tonight.
Well, the best eighth or ninth man in the conference is Jordan Grant, Coach. What a spark he gave you guys off the bench. I mean, and he looked confident doing it like he plays 28 minutes a game. 2 threes that were right on point, made a great steal, had an assist as well. I mean, he was a huge spark for you guys down the stretch in the first half.
Our guys would tell you in practice he may be one of the hardest guys to guard, and the reason being he's just really smart. He was coached very, very well at Harrison High School by David Stoller, who was a teammate of mine here at UCA, and Dave does a great job, and Jordan comes in with those fundamentals. He's kind of waited his turn, and, you know, it's always good when a guy gets rewarded for hard work, and the thing I will tell you, I have never come to practice that he wasn't the first guy on the floor. Usually he and Hayden Koval are out there shooting when we start practice, when I walk in the building prior to practice starting. So for him to get in and then have such a big, big impact, I thought he just kind of lit the spark that we needed. And the guys on the bench, you know, they were pulling for him too. And he had a big steal in front of the bench,
yeah.
And I thought that kind of got us going.
Why did you go to him so early?
You know, he's earned it, and I've been liking what I see in practice with him, and I just felt like he might hit one of those shots. I thought DJ was struggling a little bit, and so we were able to – Monty plays point guard for us, but Jordan can too, and it just seemed like a good opportunity at that moment to give it a try. And you know, sometimes, as they say, a blind squirrel finds an acorn, and I'm certainly that blind squirrel.
Well, the good news is he didn't hit one for you, Coach. He hit two,
yep,
which was good. And I tell you, the second one, he just hung his hand up there like, this is no big deal to me. I got this. I loved it. You know, obviously a lot of guys contributed. Another total team game. You had 4 guys in double figures and a couple others that just missed it. You know, again, this is such a fun team to watch and to call. And they just, you know, they don't quit. It was great that you guys didn't dig yourselves a hole. We talked about it. That first half is so critical. Now 7-0 when you lead at halftime this season.
You know, it's funny. My staff was over there a number of times saying, call timeout. And I knew we probably needed a timeout, but I also thought we needed to learn how to play through it. And that's one of the things I have to learn with this team. With a young team, sometimes it's almost like a parent, a helicopter parent. You know, they just hover over their kids so much, and they don't let them make decisions and grow. And I think coaches do that sometimes. And I felt like with this team, I've done that a little bit. And today, I wanted to just see, you know, I keep saying take ownership, but if I don't let them take ownership, it's pretty hard for them to do that. And so that part I was really pleased with. I thought they played through some mistakes. They were able to, you know, kind of self-correct, and that was big for our growth.
I thought you guys just played really free and fun. Was that a thought process this week?
You know what? I talked about that. You know, my dad comes down. My dad coached for, you know, close to 50 years, and he came to practice yesterday, and we had just a horrible practice, and I blamed it on him, but it probably was the team and me. And afterwards, we went and got some coffee, and he said, you know, he just seems like your guys aren't playing real free. And he said, you're frustrated, they're frustrated, and they just don't play free. And it offended me at first, But he was right. And so today at shoot around, I told him, you know, I want you to play through your mistakes, and I'm going to kind of leave you alone and see what you've learned, because we feel like we've taught them correct. And, you know, I sat over there, about chewed my tongue off, but I there's a couple times I did just let them go. And I think really good teams do that because they play the game. Our job's really done the day before. So I was proud of them for doing that, and they did play freer, and hopefully we can continue down that line.
Well, one thing that's for sure, Coach, and it wasn't always the case in your tenure here, if this team plays with great effort, they're good enough to beat anybody in this league.
Yeah, we have the talent, and I love, you know, you pointed out to the box score. The teams I had at Grand Canyon that were really, really good, this was their box score. You know, your leading guy had like 14, and you had a bunch of eights and sevens and nines. And when you get that, first of all, you will keep your team engaged all season long because they know they have a part of it. And you also make your opponent really struggle to know who to guard. And so I'm liking the way this thing's shaping up. And if we keep defending and we keep rebounding a little better and cut our turnovers down just a little bit, this team could really, really be good at the end of the year.
Well, only one team entered the day in Southland Conference play, and we're only a few games in without a loss, and that's Sam Houston State, and they've got a tough one tonight. So it is exactly what you anticipated, which is a wide-open race and a lot of parity. So I don't know that that's ever happened probably in Southland Conference history, that you're two or three games into the season, and there's only one team left that's unblemished.
You know, one of the things I'm challenging our staff and our players, I will be honest with you, and this, you know, this may be someone out there listening and go, you're honestly saying this publicly. I have not looked at any Southland Conference stats. I don't know what teams – I know what the team we were going to play today was doing. I don't know how it compares to others. And that's how much I believe it's a game-by-game thing. I think to start doing that stuff and see who's the leader in this and the leader in that, I think it's a waste of time, because I think right now if you can get your team honed in on Wednesday night at Incarnate Word, that's about the only thing you can really do that you can count on. And I hope that we're kind of moving in that direction, that we're not worried about who we're playing, we're worried about how we're playing, and we're going to know what they're doing, but it matters not the standings, who's done what. I really believe who gets their team right is going to be the team that wins this.
All right, Coach, thanks for the time, and congratulations on the win.
Thank you, Justin.